whipping, rag on a petty lips. I talk with that on your hip. If you ain't gon' rip it up, pop it. I'm thinking like show me a benefit. Let me dumb it down, Benjamin, Benjamin. For you, we not equivalent. Really bad, looking so innocent. Bossy predicament. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. You mad while I'm getting busy. Country girl running your city. Attitude bad on Sadidi. He only two times from the. He out like a lack, call him Ricky. And honestly, it ain't no capping it. These know we no capping it. I like with a stack in it. I'm biting, I'm biting. Stop it, cause it ain't no acting it. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. Leaving my mark like a. I see no biggie. Call me Hillary Stead. Making moves like I'm hot in the shank. I'm low key, but I pop out in black. This bun on my knife, I'm trying to look. They do not cover me. Fake, I can't keep no company. Only the real respect, my honest. So watch how you come in if y'all under me. I'm with it in racks involved. All that text and calls. Just run me that making no sense at all. That bounce like a basketball. Your boo never coming back. This girl stupid, go dumb. Told that boy you gotta pay for some. I sit on no prom, you ain't taking none. You bragging on pants, I make for fun. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pity. You mad while I'm getting busy. Country girl running your city. Attitude bad on Sadidi. He only two times on the. He out like a lack, call him Ricky. And honestly, it ain't no capping it. These know ain't no capping it. I like with a stack in it. I'm biting, I'm biting. Stop it, cause it ain't no acting it. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. Leaving my mark like a.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to historic Baltimore, Maryland and M&T Bank Stadium. Today, after a crazy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here between the Minnesota Vikings and the Baltimore Ravens. Games out of the way, time to buckle down for the long season ahead, and we're off in week two. Taken at the goal line. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Jet sweep to start the drive. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
Well, they gave up a few yards there, but all in all, I think it's a pretty nice job defensively against the Jet sweep. If they don't slow him up,
here we go.
He might take it to the house. So they'll take that play every time on the defensive side of the ball.
Go.
From the 31, Burrow. The man downfield is Davis. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That one good for 26 and a first down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs as we just saw there.
Now Burrow on first down. He'll dump this off to Cook. And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it. It really gets them amped up as they go forward.
It's brought in by and he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 21. That one good for 16 as the drive continues. Now the Iowa State product, it's Kane Nwangu. And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Now it's Burrow. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26 yard line. Beautifully, that one's gonna hurt.
Here we go, here we go.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. Flushed out right. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth. I think any team probably would have touchdowns to try to help cause. But in this case, he did get a little closer, at least, if they think a field goal turns out to be the better call here. Zerline's kick is up and through, and the Vikings have a 3-0 lead. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points, maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. Room here to run! And all the way in for the Ravens touchdown! Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown score or yardage?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they'll have those types of goals, they'll have those types of thoughts, and then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Vikings now to start their next drive. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six.
It's not a surprise when you read scouting reports and watch tape because you know he's a heck of a player. But he is so difficult to get down in the open field.
On one, right?
They just want to get him the ball and let him do his thing.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Here's Burrow. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo.
A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response. And he gets this inside the 10 to the 9. It's also a gain of 9.
How about that shuffle pass? Or if you want to call it the shuffle pass, that's fine too. That's one of those plays that you take a little bit of risk there because you're trying to throw the ball into the middle of the field where a lot of big bodies lurk, and they can knock it away, pick it off, but they were able to execute it successfully on that play.
On second down, Cook. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up first and goal.
Now, that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork, and add in a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
They'll run with Cook, and he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Dalvin Cook, his third rushing touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are once again back in front. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This one fielded at the 5. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
The last run got 6. Now 2nd and 4. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. The Ravens had 0-1 on the year following the loss in the opener.
And they were given a gift to 2 straight home games to start the campaign. Dropped one of them already. You have to figure a split of these two probably imperative.
And they did talk about that with us prior to the game, about how important it is to start the season 1-1, especially with 2 games at home. Because if you go 0-2, hard to make those up on the road as the season progresses.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5. They'll go again with Dobbins. And able to get this one across the 45. Good for 13 and a lead of first down. 10-7 our score after 1. 2nd quarter now from Baltimore. It's the Ravens in possession as they've got it with a 1st and 10. And now Jackson will look to throw it. They set up the screen for Dobbins. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work this to the 45. On 2nd down, a run with Dobbins. On a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. 116 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. This offense hoping to avoid the 0-2 start. They trail, but they've got a 1st and 10 here. Now Jackson taps this forward, jet sweep, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
They go play action now. Jackson. Throw here's incomplete.
And the end result of that play, you're almost not sure what you really want, because when he gets outside of the pocket, you actually hold your breath because you think he's going to run for big yardage. But when he chose to pull it down and throw it, and a play was made to knock it away, that's a pretty good end result. Not one you expected when the play began.
Play action. It's Jackson. They'll roll him out right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long, why are you calling play action?
Yeah, because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and the line blocking. But to me, it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and that leads to a play action sack. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. The offense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I'll guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there, because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
And they were backed up to start the drive, but not anymore. Now, that's the play call that the offensive coordinator had in his head. He saw the end result. He wanted to go ahead and push the ball downfield, and that's what they did. And they wound up with good yardage there to get things rolling.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. Swinging this out wide here for Cook. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 34 yards to gain that time, another first down.
I think this defense was still trying to recover from that last play, so you wonder if they were ready for this one. You have to imagine their defensive coaches are yelling at them to get focused, because if they don't, more plays like that will result in giving up points.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, three plays, three first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they get to that end zone real fast.
From the red zone now, here's Burrow, first down. Big loss here as he's taken down. Justin Matabike working his way to the quarterback at the time.
That was a passer's nightmare. A front door totally shut down by the defense. So he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
11 mighty. 11 mighty.
Another try after the first down sack. Burrow. And oh, that would get a write-up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone. Probably should have been. Third down coming up.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one. Weren't able to do so.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
11-11.
Burrow will throw. He wants it all for the end zone. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. A great effort there. 34 yards as they have taken the lead. Zerline good with a PAT, and that makes it a 17-10 score. Minnesota's kick team ready, and the Vikings boom it away. This will be returned from deep in the end zone.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They find themselves down 17-10 as they come up on a first and 10. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line after the loss to start out. Here's second and 11. Throwing is Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. On third down, Jackson. Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. Multiple players getting home there for an 8-yard loss. Fourth down, and out comes Jordan Stout here to punt. Yikes, terrible kick headed straight for the sideline. And they're going to be set up with excellent field position to start the drive as that gets out of bounds inside the 45-yard line.
Here we go, here we go.
First down, here's Burrow. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. The Vikings going to signal for the first down timeouts as he'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Another try after the first down sack. Burrow. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sacked on first down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Burrow looking to pass. It's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
That's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come to the completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
The Vikings send out their punter as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. This will be fielded at the 17. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the Ravens, they'll take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And the slot man goes in motion left. On first and 10, it's Jackson. That's into a crowd and intercepted. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
Here we go.
first down. Here's the run with Cook. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime.
On two, ready?
The last run got 9. That leaves him with second and a yard.
12.
From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. That's to Cook out of the backfield. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line. Cook up the gun. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward.
If you're a coach, you'll absolutely take that run every time on first down because it really sets you up to go in a number of directions here on second.
Here we go.
Second down and 5.
11.
From the shotgun, it's Burrow. That one thrown away from the pocket. The officials kind of looking at each other, but they'll say there was a receiver in the area, so no penalty, just an incomplete pass.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Zerline's kick is up and through, and they double him up here. That makes our score 20-10.
So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense. The firemen, go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. The Ravens set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
And right out of the gate, they face what you think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so. You know, they're down 2 scores. That's not the end of the world. It wasn't the strongest of first halves, but for them to start calling back, they've got to start putting a little pressure on that defense, start cutting into this deficit. You can't have 3 and outs and expect to get that done.
So this play, you know, until recently, only something you'd probably expect to see in a college game, but running quarterbacks are certainly in vogue, and this turned into a big play.
And you and I both know that for a long time, coaches worried about their quarterbacks taking too much punishment running plays like this, and they still worry about it. But when you can break up big chunks of yardage like that, it's worth the risk. Plus, you're coaching that quarterback to see those guys coming and get down before the big hit occurs.
And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll have a 2nd and 1 forthcoming.
Yeah.
And not much running room. Down to the 32. He could muster only a yard there, and they'll be left with a 3rd and very short.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And down he goes. Raiders taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. 142 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
They'll run with Dobbins. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Jackson's going to keep it. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. They lost 4 there, and it's third down.
Considering they've seen him have some big gains against them throughout this game, that's got to feel like a measure of revenge as they trap him behind the line of scrimmage for a loss.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Lewis Seen.
They were well aware of the scoreboard as they went into halftime, and they know how tough it's been to put up any kind of points. But if there's a positive after that play, is that they were able to take a shot at the end zone on their opening drive of this half. The negative, though, that shot at 6 ended in an interception, and we know that's not going to jumpstart this struggling offense.
From the pistol, they run it with Cook. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. They go play action with Burrow. Blitz coming, and down he goes. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack. And it'll lead to a 3rd and long. I'm sure a lot of time was spent in the locker room, Charles, and talking with his defense about setting a tone here in the third quarter when you're down on the scoreboard. A sack like that, maybe that can get them going.
Yeah, you have to believe exactly what you just said. That they got together and said, let's be some change agents here. Let's go ahead and turn things around. Let's be the force that gets us going here in the second half and puts us in a position to find a way to win the game.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Able to convert on 3rd and 14. A terrific play call. This offense really looking polished these first couple of weeks. Here's 1st and 10. They'll try the middle with Cook. And a hard-working run here as he's got it inside the 20, down to the 17. A gain of 10 as they look to add on to this 10-point lead. Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they're able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of 3.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
On 2nd and 7, Burrow. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. DeMond Clark leading the surge there as he drops him for a loss of 6.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen, but somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking a lead, and thus far, it hasn't happened. Time's winding down. They don't want to waste this type of performance from these ace pass rushers.
That's going to be caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Here we go. 11 MP paint.
Burrow going to keep it himself. And he will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. Joe Burrow with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Vikings will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Minnesota's kick team ready, and the Vikings boom it away. Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone.
The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in the second half. He gets this underneath to Dobbins. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. Back now in Baltimore. It's the Ravens with possession of football, but trailing on the big board as we get set for the fourth. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. He's got his man, it's Andrews. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Off the play fake to Dobbins, here's Jackson. He's going to look deep down the field. And this one is incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break. And you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
They'll try to draw here with Dobbins. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10, right at the 40. Another run here with Dobbins. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Now on second and 13, Jackson. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Oh, and for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. It's Cameron Dantzler who picks it. And the Vikings are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. Well, offensively, Charles, hard to put a silver lining on this one. No secret that they had to take chances with the score where it is, and it leads to a turnover.
I love how you paint the picture, partner, because you're exactly right about that one. Look at the empty stares on that sideline. This is one of those games we just want to go crawl under a rock until it's over.
They'll rumble for about six up across the 20 to the 22. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
4 yards the pickup, first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
They'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. Setting up the screen for Cook. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They get 14 there. First down, Vikings.
Well, partner, they've used him quite well out of the backfield in this one. And here's another nice example. They set up the screen, and he's able to pick his way downfield for a nice gain there.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Burrow, dancing to his left. Open man downfield is Davis. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Give him 30 yards there.
No let up in this passing game. They've been a well-oiled machine throughout. And I actually saw a few guys on the sidelines at the end of the third quarter doing the old hold up four fingers college sign, meaning the fourth quarter is ours. And they certainly weren't kidding.
Now Burrow on first down. Now this is intercepted. He was trying to get it to Davis. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And the Ravens are going to get the football back at their own 17. Their passing game has been spectacular this afternoon. Finally, a win for the defense.
You think maybe there was an adjustment there. Finally gained a measure of, I don't even know if you call it revenge, but got a play done against him, and that's been difficult for them all game long.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Here's a quick hitch route and the throw complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30. 12 yards to pick up there. Good for a Raven first. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now Jackson. Oh, looking for Andrews downfield. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Jackson's throw into the hands of Andrews. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. Jackson will throw again. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
11 MT paint.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Armour Davis. And the Ravens are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Well, they're not making it easy on themselves here down the stretch. 2 picks now in the fourth quarter, trying to hang on to that lead.
Talk about keeping someone in the game. Instead of being able to shut the door, it's still cracked open because they can come back on you now. The only people are really happy about those picks, any fantasy team that has this defense.
So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. So first and 10 now from the 30. Jackson. And that'll be complete to Dobbins. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33. Throwing again on second down. Jackson. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. Jackson looking to throw on third. And he's got his tight end. That's Andrews. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 40. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. From their own 40 to the other 40. The gain of 20 leads to first and 10. And now here is another interception. Andrew Booth picks it off. And the Vikings
Eagles are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line. I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now five times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have